Hey everyone, Rodney here at Cleves Tech, and today we're going to be talking about Free You and Focus. Free what, you ask? Well, Free You, Free Lunch, and Diffusion UNet. Yeah, I know, that didn't really explain anything. Now, this is not specific to Focus only, but I have had a few people ask about the settings in Focus. Where are these settings, you ask? Well, they happen to be hidden in the debug settings, and I did some research and experimenting to hopefully give you some information about them. I'm not going to be giving a super detailed explanation of Free You since I don't have a complete understanding myself, and I couldn't find a lot of detailed information online, but I will show you some examples of what it can do. Now, the claim is that Free You can be used to improve image quality without extra training. As for if it automatically improve image quality, that is hard to say yes or no. Found for some things it did and others it did not. But the biggest thing I did discover is there's no correct setting. I did some digging online, came up with some recommended settings, and went ahead and tried those out. I would love to go through every possible setting to show comparisons, but that would be pretty time consuming, and I don't think it would really show much. As with many of these things, what looks best for one person might not to another. So where do we find the Free You settings in Focus? Well, you're gonna go into the Advanced tab and then the Developer Debug Mode, and then you're gonna find the Free You tab in there. And when you wanna use it, make sure you enable it. If you just move the sliders, it won't do anything. Now, as for what those do, the B value is the backbone, the S is for the skip connections. So the B value modifies mostly the core part of the image, the backbone, and focuses on the main structure of the image. And the S value emphasizes more on the finer details and the textures. Now, as for which recommended settings to be used, that I did some digging online. I found a few different ones from the GitHub page and some other sources and went with those for SDXL and showing some of my examples. You're gonna find a lot of it is all subjective on whether you think those are best or not. For some images, I found they worked well. For other images, not so well. And I think these two images will give you an idea. So in the top left was my initial images, starting with everything set as one. And then I slowly lowered the S values to get down to the last one. And it's pretty noticeable how it reduces the textures and the details in the image by lowering that S value. Similarly, with this image, I went the opposite direction and I left the B values at one and I increased them over that. Now, I didn't find many that suggested doing that, but I wanted to see what would happen. And as it went through, you can see added textures and details. It makes the image look pretty bad once you get to a certain point. So that gives you a little bit of an idea of what those values might do. Okay, so now to start to look at the images that I ran through just for comparison. I won't spend a bunch of time on each one. You can make your decision, pause it, look at it if you want to. So the center one is without the Free You. So for this one, I actually think that one's better in my opinion. But again, it really depends on what you're trying to get out of that image. A lot of times I found I've been messing around with it, and what I'll do is I'll generate an image. And if I like the image for the most part, want to tweak it, I'll go into the Free You settings and tweak those a little bit to try to either increase, lower details, things like that. And for our mushroom scene with the giant glowing mushrooms, same idea. Definitely the center image has more detail in it and looks more realistic for magic mushrooms, I guess. You can definitely see with some of the other images, lower details and textures. And if that's what you're trying to get out of the picture, then that might be what you want to do in adjusting the Free You. Now for our wizard, similar idea. As with any of these, it really comes down to the style and look. It's almost like a different style for some of these images on how it comes out. Sometimes it actually improves the image in other ways. I personally here like the bottom right one myself. Now for this one, I think this demonstrates how sometimes with the realistic images, you can end up with oversaturation down the bottom left, especially, or even a little bit on the top left. So a lot of times it can be just a balance of adjusting those numbers slightly. And for the woman eating a burger, same idea. Some of these definitely don't look that realistic. So if you're looking for a more photorealistic one, the Free You disabled on this one I feel is probably better, or even the top right. Now for our tranquil forest at sunrise, I'm a big fan of the one without Free You on this one. But again, that's if I'm going for more photorealistic, whereas these other ones definitely have a different style to them in that sense. Now for our still life of assorted fruits, I think that almost all of the Free You ones are better than the original one. So I think this example shows that in some images, it definitely can make a big improvement. Now the astronaut one, here. I'm not seeing much of a difference between all of them. So overall, I couldn't say whether that would make a difference. I probably wouldn't mess around with it after trying a few different settings. I'd realize that maybe I'm not going to get anything different. Now, our Viking ship, same idea. The center one might look more realistic in that sense, but I actually like some of the other ones. So I think in here it demonstrates what you can get for different looks from an image by adjusting those settings. And a similar results with this. You can definitely see the differences between these and the lower details. Now, a lot of stuff I read online said that anime was better versus the photorealistic ones, which may be the case, especially depending on how much detail you want to add or the textures and things like that. I'm not huge on anime, so I can't really say a lot of comparisons whether I think one of these is better than the other. And similar with this one. A lot of these, it's hard for me to say. You know, you can see the differences, but I don't know necessarily which is better or not with a lot of these. Now, for this example, I went with a more photorealistic one. I liked most of the results of these. Depending on how I'd want that image to look. I mean, the bottom left one here, I'm not a big fan of. I think it looks too fake. But most of the other ones, I think, actually came out pretty well. I think those could definitely have, I could say, definitely improve those images. So what's the best way to use FreeU? What I've been usually doing is once I generate images, if I want to play around with it, I get the image that's pretty close to what I want. A lot of times I'll go in, I'll check this off, get that enabled. Now, I want to get the same image, of course, so I'm going to go into here, uncheck random, and I'll set my seed the same. So now I have my two images, and I'm going to adjust it on these. So at this point, I would just go ahead, enter in the changes I want. So we're going to get generate based upon that same seed, so I can adjust these to see how it impacts the image. Now, I'm also going to change this down to just one. I'm just going to go with this first image and have it generate that. And then I can go ahead and compare them and see if I like the results. If I don't like the results, then I can continue tweaking further. Now the one on the left here is the one that I just adjusted versus the one on the right. And then I can continue adjusting from there depending on what I want to do. So that's pretty much how I've been playing around with it and testing it. And the problem is there's no real guaranteed settings, but I think if you play around with enough, you get a feeling for what each one will do and how it may impact the image that you're working on. And so I would suggest keep playing around with it and discovering what you can do with that. I do plan on, you know, I've used it a few times on images that came out pretty close to what I wanted. I tweaked it around a little bit, but I will admit overall I don't use it a lot yet, so we'll see how that goes. I think that covers what I've learned so far with FreeU and what I wanted to pass along. Hopefully it gives you an idea of what you can do with it and maybe start getting better images. Sadly, I don't have all the answers when it comes to FreeU because I haven't had enough time to really experiment enough with it. I have not made up my mind on if it makes better images or not. I think it just makes them different. If you found the video helpful, please consider hitting the like button. And don't forget, keep on creating.